Hi everybody! Today I'll show and explain to you another extraordinary feature coming with VSDC version 6.9, the so-called LUT editor or LUT editor. So let's go right away into it! LUT comes from lookup table, and it is the favorite color correction tool. The new LUT editor coming with version 6.9 does not only enable you to adjust colors very accurately and flexibly, but also to save your own LUT configurations into files, and so they can be reused at any moment. So let's take a closer look at this feature. We import the video, a magnificent landscape, and go to the resources window. Now we click on the plus symbol and click on Create LUT, since we first want to create a new one. You see there's a new resource type on 6.9, which has a .cube extension. Now we see our first LUT or LUT there, having a default name empty LUT. We can give our own convenient name, for example, Summer. In order to be able to see what we're doing, this LUT must be applied to an object, in this case, to our video. So we go inside it and drag the LUT resource into the timeline. Now we have an LUT or LUT object within our video, thus acting upon it. Now to start editing, we double click on the left end of the resource, which finally opens the editor window. The upper row contains the name of the actual LUT, so here you can change the name too, but we already chose a name, Summer, so we'll leave it like that. The graphic at the left is a color space histogram. If you take the central point, you see the enormous changes that it produces on our video. Let's reset all, and so we go to the absolute beginning without any change. This we can apply at any moment if we see we are going in the absolutely wrong direction. You can reset and you start from scratch. Or you can go one by one step rearwards or forwards. Now, the three small columns at the center are responsible for HSL adjustments, hue, saturation, lightness adjustments. Histogram allows us to select the type of histogram we want, either perspective or orthographic. The first one, perspective, includes brightness values, but the orthographic one does nothing. So for our purpose, we select perspective. Sizes allows us to determine the number of sections on the grid. The more sections or control points we have, the more precise we can choose the color tones to adjust. Hue, saturation, and lightness controls allow us to adjust HSL values for the actually selected control points. And the lowest row here is of great help for point selection. So let's select one point, for example, this one. Now all these controls become active, and also this one. So if we selected this dot or this point there, and we say select the ray, means that you can select the complete ray containing that point. Or here you would select a circle. Here you would select everything or unselect everything. Select everything, unselect everything. It's a toggle button. So if we have already one point selected, this allows us to select the whole circle around this point. Or select the outer circle, it just does what it says. Or select the center point, it does what it says. But let's suppose that we have this point selected, and then we select a whole ray, and then go to this button here, which is to increase the selection. You see, the actual selection was increased on both sides, or decrease it. Or we can also draw with the mouse a rectangle, and all these dots would be selected in that case. If you want to deselect all of them, we can depress once and twice, and all the points are deselected.
Meet me. Meet me. Follow me. Follow me.
Now let's try to give our video a summer feeling. For this, we should make the greens even greener, deeper, more saturated. We use the HSL columns to constrain our adjustments to only the green color range. This is highly important, since it means that even if we move control points outside this color range, they won't change. So let's do it. It's about that. You see, if you click and maintain the left button clicked, you see which region or sector of the whole circle is the one that can be influenced by point movement. The rest won't. So let's click on one of these points, which more or less would be in the middle of the whole range, and let's select ray, and also increase selection. So now we have about what we need. All the points here are more or less within the constraint range. So now we go to this point up about in the middle of this constraint range and start moving the whole structure towards more saturated greens. You see what happens. Only the greens are in fact being influenced, and that's exactly what we need. All the other colors should remain as they are. We play around until we find a position that we like most. It could be this one. Okay, so now we press OK and it's done. So the LUT called Summer is ready, but so far only available within the actual project. The good news is we can reuse this LUT or any other you create or edit, and for this you have to export it into a file. Let's do it. So now, just to show you the whole process, let's get rid of the local resource Summer. We click on it and delete it. As you see, it's gone. But we have not lost it because we saved it before. So now we go to Add Media, Add LUT, go to the previously saved file, .cube, and open it. The only thing that we are missing now is we have to drag this resource into the timeline. And voila, our effect is there again. And finally, to round off this topic, I'll show you a nice video which I created using a sequence of LUT effects on an original video. Let's take a look. Amazing, isn't it? In fact, the more we get into VSDC, the more we perceive that this tool enables us to do almost everything to create, improve, or tweak our videos at will, only limited by our own creativity. Well, this is all for today, my friends. If you liked it, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel so that you won't miss any of my future publications. Bye-bye, and see you soon again.